Right now on Party Heat. Partiers are underdressed.
When diapers go in the water, they expand and they come apart. If I see that diaper floating in the... Shut up and listen to me, please. You're going to be cited for littering.
And over the limit.
You are, oh my God, drunk. 0.40 is legally dead. You are a 0.3.
You kidding me?
I'm not kidding you.
Deputies rush to the scene when a parasailer gets blown off course.
Parachute caught her, took her, slid face forward, and then plopped into the rocks.
I feel like my body's going into shock.
Another day on the lake. It's about 115, supposed to reach 125 again today. This place will be filling up in no time.
A different scene, but it's the same thing going on. You got people partying, drinking, getting out of control.
Hangover or not, they're coming out here to party, and we'll be here to watch.
When it gets this crowded out on the water, we really try and make our presence known.
With multiple party hotspots and over 90 miles of shoreline, deputies are stretched to the limit.
We're definitely outnumbered out here. Got the about four boats that work on the lake compared to the 2,000 boats that'll be out here for people having fun.
We're gonna head on into the channel and see what we got today. What is that guy doing? Hey, Ken, turn around and stop this guy. He's out of the boat.
Who?
That guy right over here.
We were just trying to put the ladder up. That's okay. All we're trying to do.
I'm sorry, we were trying to put the ladder in and up and in.
Gotcha, but with you guys in the water and the prop running, it's a recipe for disaster, okay, guys?
Oh.
That's why we're stopping you.
Driver, can you come across for me real quick?
Watch your head.
The reason we stopped you is for the guys hanging over the side of your boat while your vessel's underway. Can't do that, okay? Yeah. If they slip...
I didn't even know that the guy that was... But he said he was putting the letter on top on us.
Okay, yeah. Had anything to drink today?
Yeah.
Okay. Tip your sunglasses up for me. First thing you're gonna do is you're gonna close your eyes and tilt your head back when I tell you to do so. Not right now. You're gonna hold your fist down at your side with your index fingers exposed. No, sit down. Sit down. You're gonna stay seated for the whole thing, okay? With your fingers out just like this. When I say left or right, you will bring the pad of your left or right index finger to the tip of your nose, just like this. Are you watching me? Okay. And then you'll put them back on your own. I won't tell you to put them back. Put them back on your own. Left. Put them back on your own. I won't tell them to put you back, okay? Put your finger back, sir. There you go. Right? Okay, put it back on your own. I won't tell you to do so. Put it back on your own. Okay. I want you to take a deep breath and blow on this machine just like you're blowing up a balloon. Deep breath. Blow hard. Blow harder. Keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going. Good job. So you can see the same thing that I'm seeing. Okay, you're twice the legal limit. You understand that? Okay, what's gonna happen now is you're being placed under arrest for operating a vessel under the influence. Okay, you're not gonna give me any problems today. I don't have to handcuff you. Okay.
Officer.
Yes.
Originally, I was the one driving, except
okay.
I didn't know how to maneuver it.
Okay,
so
well,
to
here's-
to be completely honest with you, when he jumped out of the boat, I told him to hold on to the wheel because I keep sticking my boy.
Sit down, sit down, sit down.
At the moment that I took-
Okay, I understand your dilemma, okay? He's under arrest for driving under the influence. He's over twice the legal limit, okay? Okay, and I understand that. He'll be released in 5 to 6 hours, but I can't let him leave, and I need to make sure that someone sober is able to drive, okay? You have kids on the boat. It's important to everybody, all right? Unfortunately, they really didn't want to have their friend and family member arrested, and they were all out here to have a good time, and she accused us of ruining their weekend. I guess in some aspects, from a certain point of view, you could say we ruined their weekend, but we probably saved someone's life getting a driver that's over twice the legal limit off of the water operating that vessel when there was children on board.
There's a lot of people out here and don't realize how dangerous boating is. A lot of congestion. If we weren't out here, it'd be a madhouse. And I think just by us being out here and doing what we do, let people have that thought in their mind. There could be a patrol boat behind them anytime, and it keeps everybody in check. We got a jet boat. It just sprayed another jet boat over here. Reckless operations. We're going to go stop them.
Yeah.
Do I need to even tell you why I'm stopping you?
The jet evader. I had
I hit it and I hit the bumps and it was loose.
Right over the other boat. Is he a buddy of yours or what?
Yeah.
So you were just being stupid then, huh?
Yeah. He did me earlier and it's like I hit the bump. I put it up. I wasn't going to get him and I hit the water. Kind of rough out here.
You know how dangerous it is? You know how illegal it is? You know what could happen, right?
Yeah.
You've been drinking today at all?
Earlier I had a beer.
Let me take a look at your ride real quick.
See, I'm blind. I need prescription glasses.
Okay.
If you want to look through them, you're going to hurt your eyes.
That's fine. I'll just tell you what I do. Let me look at your eyes real quick without them. Okay? You don't have to just kind of see this. Kind of just follow it if you can.
That's kind of hard.
You're fine.
I had one beer. I know better.
Firm, go ahead.
Deputy McComas radios dispatch to run a background check.
It just came up. You have a couple of assault with deadly weapons, a couple of brandishing.
I don't do that no more. I'm young and dumb. Now, the assault with deadly weapon was, we had a party going on. We locked the guns in the room. The neighbors broke into the room and stole them. So we came out front with them, and of course, the sheriffs were there. Boom, right behind, just dropped me. Another one was a car.
Unfortunately for you, Ricky, I've been working this detail for 4 years. Okay. Seen a lot of people using a jet abater, and it's, you know, pretty much legal when you're not around another boat. But this is the first time I've seen anybody blatantly do it like you did.
I didn't even see you guys.
I'm going.
Earlier, so
I do not believe you did that right in front of me.
I didn't even see you.
You drenched that boat.
Good, because that's what they did to us, and I was so bad at them.
Well, that's good, but it's not good if somebody gets killed doing it.
I don't like it. I'm always telling them, don't do it.
Okay, citations for illegal spraying, signing that box. Not Mitch Gill, I promise you'll take care of it. Obviously, like I said, I could have done you for the reckless operation and be booking you in the jail, but again, good attitude goes a long ways out here. Okay? Taking a lot of water. That just goes to show you, with this statement that it doesn't matter if they know it's illegal or not. As long as they think there's not a cop around, they're going to try their luck at it. Unfortunately, luck ran out today.
Coming up on Party Heat.
0.40 is legally dead. You are a 0.3, kidney.
How did I blow that high?
I don't know.
Good. You think that I'd be dead?
Well,
you should be.
You're creeping up on it.
Then.
If I see that diaper floating in the, shut up and listen to me, please. If it's floating in the water and coming apart, you're going to get a ticket for littering.
Put it back on?
Put it back on.
In general, our biggest goal in the Marine Enforcement Unit is education. Unfortunately, there is no legislation in place for people to get formal training before they're able to get out on the water with a boat. That is what leads to a lot of our accidents and a lot of our injuries. So most of what we do out here is stop people and just advise them of what they can and cannot do. There's somebody sitting on the transom, and I think we need to go address that issue.
Hey guys, how's it going?
Good, how are you?
Good, good.
You
think the orders for stopping you today?
No.
Okay.
They cannot be on the front.
Oh, I know. It's just about lake speeds.
No, because if he has to maneuver violently for any reason, to avoid somebody or somebody else doing something
and
stupid,
I slip off.
And you slide off, and he's still looking at the stupid guy.
It looks like our fault.
You hit the prop, and then you become chump. And that sucks because there's pieces of you everywhere, and we got to go pick it up.
Okay.
Driver, come on over here.
Watch your step.
Can I have you have a seat right here? I'm going to do what's called a couple of field sobriety tests real quick. I want to make sure that you're safe and sober enough to operate your vessel with all your buddies on board, okay?
Okay.
First test I'm going to have you do, when I tell you to, I'm going to have you tilt your head back and close your eyes. You're going to have your arms at your side like this with your index fingers pointed outward. What I'm going to do is I'm going to say left or right. When I say left, you're going to bring your left finger, the pad of your index finger, to the tip of your nose. Take it back on your own. When I say right, you're going to do the same thing with the right, put it back on your own. I'll do three on each side. Okay, are you ready?
Yep.
Go ahead and relax those down at your side. Down, there you go. Extend your index fingers. Left. There you go. Right. Left.
Oh, that's pretty.
Right. Right. And left. Okay, the last test I want to have you do is blow into what's called a preliminary alcohol screening device. What I need you to do is just take a deep breath, wrap your lips around it like a balloon, and blow hard. Ready? Deep breath. Blow. Blow, 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 blow. Keep going, keep going. Keep going, keep going, keep going. Keep going, keep going.
No, let me come around here. I've already watched you breathing. I know you can take a full breath and blow.
All right.
If you make me reset this machine again, I'm going to take you to jail, and we're going to use a breath machine there.
Okay.
Deep breath and blow.
Whatever you guys want me to do.
Okay. Unfortunately, at this time, I'm going to have to place you under arrest for boating under the influence. Dude, you're like really, really high.
I understand. Okay. But what am I doing in my boat?
Okay.
Heather.
We can park it on the shore. Is there somebody that knows how to operate your boat? You're comfortable?
Only me.
Okay. All right. Here's what we can do. We can make sure that it gets to shore. Once it's in shore, you're going to be released in about 5 to 7 hours. You'll be able to retrieve it tonight.
Now, this is a $500,000 boat.
I agree. It's a beautiful boat. Do you want us to impound it for you? Do you want us to tow it for you?
No, but...
What would you? I'm willing to work with you, bro.
Anybody else be able to drive it?
Yeah.
Right. No, that's what I'm saying. I was wondering, like, I'd say if you guys could, like, sign it.
5-5-3-1. Long and short of it was, we stopped him for a real minor violation. Some of his buddies were riding on the bow of the boat. Bow riding, as it turns out, after a brief investigation, the driver is pretty much 4 times the legal limit.
Okay. How'd I blow that high?
Dude, I don't
good
know.
Good. That, you think that I'd be dead?
Well,
I should be.
You're creeping up on it. You're creeping up to being seriously unconscious.
And 6 kids.
That, well, I can
understand.
3.
I can understand.
I just got divorced again in Burley. And this is probably why I'm acting like stupid.
Nah, dude, everybody makes mistakes, man. He was harder on himself than we were on him. He was really not happy with himself for endangering his friends and being that drunk. He just really thought it was a stupid thing. So hopefully he learned his lesson and we won't have to deal with him anymore.
Coming up on Party Heat.
We got a couple guys here that are wearing, look like maybe adult diapers in the water.
Then... Deputy Moyer fights to keep a parasailer from going into shock.
The medics don't get here soon, you could go into shock.
We just arrived in Copper Canyon. Over here and take a look and see how many boats are in the canyon, and we'll make a pass through here, let them see the star on the side of the boat, and let them know that we're out and about, and that usually keeps things in order for the most part. We got 2 jet skis up here that were splashing each other, operating at a high rate of speed real close to shore, so we're going to go contact them and inform them of the violation. Here we go. Pull it to the beach. Got some reckless operation going on out there. How you doing, buddy?
Good.
I'm Deputy McComas. You're being stopped because you're reckless operation out there.
Okay,
when you splash people like that, you're not allowed to do that.
Yeah.
Were you aware of that?
No. Well, now I know.
You probably were, but you're like, eh.
No, it's just I didn't know you can, like, just splash a friend, like, right over here or whatever.
You don't think it's reckless or dangerous?
Well, I mean, it could be, but, I mean.
But what?
I don't know. Figured we knew what we were doing.
Oh, dude, he started it. He deserves to go to jail.
No, he started the splashing.
What about the pokey?
You taunted me.
I taunted you?
Yeah, you taunted
by
me.
By stopping my little thing out there and you drove by like 80 miles per hour?
Oh, don't even start.
He's a reckless driver.
You know you started
you
yesterday.
You are a reckless driver.
You know, regardless, you can't be doing that, okay? How long have you been operating the ski?
A while. I mean, I don't do it like every day, but... I've done it.
But you got a lot of experience, right?
Yeah.
Just for an example, a couple weeks ago, we had two girls, friends, 29 years old, been on sea dues all their life, you know, plenty of experience. Launch them, start off upriver, maybe a minute on the water. Riding like this, one decided to turn, the other one couldn't stop, hits her, her left leg's amputated. Gone. And these are experienced people, so I mean, they're dangerous no matter who you are, you just gotta be careful. Okay, here's the deal. I'm gonna give you a written warning.
Okay, hopefully this will be enough just to get your head going. Maybe I better not do that, because next time I'll give you a real one. Okay, it'll cost you about $500 or whatever the case may be. I don't know what the course
that
cost.
That would raise my irritation level really high.
Exactly.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Lucky number 7.
There's your copy. Just a warning. Do whatever you need to do with it, but let it be fresh in your head that if I see you doing it again.
I'm gonna
hang
it in my room.
Yeah, we're gonna
look at it. Both of them had real good attitude. I was able to get through to them how important it is to be safe, and that no matter how much experience you have, anything can happen out here, especially when you're driving reckless like that. I think giving them the warning citation that I did is going to be enough to get their little brain spinning inside, saying that maybe we shouldn't do what we were doing.
2 miles south of Copper Canyon, crowds have begun to gather in Steamboat Cove.
Steamboat Cove's about 4 times the size of Copper Canyon. Copper Canyon is more of a bowl. This is more of a long cylinder shape. So you have a couple little cove areas that you can squirrel yourself away into. More commonly, this is more of a family atmosphere than Copper Canyon is a party atmosphere, but you can still get an awful lot of boats and an awful lot of folks here having a good time.
Going to Palm 3, we have a report of a boating accident. We want female injured.
25 Palm 3. We just got a call of an injury boat collision. It sounds like there's a female that has back injury, so we'll go figure out what kind of crash we have and see what we've got to do. Trim it up.
25-3, 25-1. Also information, CSO's in route.
Now, what do we got?
Parasailing accident. The parachute caught her, took her, she slid face. She hit the little clip and then plopped into the rocks too, so.
We need medics here.
Okay, got it.
She's been down about 20.
Deputy Moyer calls in EMS.
25-3.
You have Lake Havasu City Fire respond. We have complaint of pain and head and neck injury. Okay, well, right now she's just cold and a little shocking, so until they get here, we got a dry towel coming right now, that'll help.
Here we go, this is dry.
Let's see if I got that. Let me get that blanket out of the comb.
Yeah, she got drugged through the scorpion.
It really is hard to see somebody in that much pain, but you got to remember that with this type of an injury, if we don't have the proper equipment and we try to move them, it could do more harm than good, so we have to wait.
Well, if the medics don't get here soon, with her being in the cold water the way she is, she could go into shock.
Coming up on Party Heat.
I really feel like my body is going to stop.
Well, spinal injury could range from anywhere from extreme discomfort to paralysis.
Don't move your head.
A woman has been seriously injured in a parasailing accident.
The girl was parasailing behind her father's boat, and she hit the water and then got dragged right through the bushes.
Hey, bud. Okay, what's hurting you right now, huh?
I really feel like my body is going to stop.
We're going to roll her on her right side, check her back and her neck, and then we'll get her on the board.
Ready to go on three. One, two, three.
We're
just
going to
relax, okay? Let's do it.
Relax.
Does it hurt on your back, right down here?
Yeah, it hurts.
Don't move your head.
We're going to get you out of the water.
Okay, we're going to rotate you back. Just relax, okay?
On three. One, two, three.
We're going to do a couple of things to you when we get you in the boat, okay? We're going to get your vitals and blood pressure cup on your arm, and I'm going to start an ID on you too, okay? This is a precaution, and we'll take you down to the hospital and get you checked out. Okay? So hang tight with us, keep your arms crossed across your chest. We're gonna move the backboard, it's gonna feel a little awkward, and we're gonna put you into the police boat here, okay?
Well, right now it's impossible to gauge the extent of her injuries. With a possible spinal injury, it could range from anywhere from extreme discomfort to paralysis.
We arrived, we had a female patient that possibly had some spinal injuries. We just put her in full C-spine, transported her to Havasu Regional Medical Center, and hopefully she won't have any problems from it, but it's one of those things, you take a risk when you're out here doing private parasailing.
people get a little careless out here. You know, there's no seat belts or anything like that in the boat to protect, and unfortunately they end up suffering the results when they get an accident.
Back at Copper Canyon, Deputy McComas is looking for trouble.
Pretty easy to pick out who the trouble people are just by looking where the crowds are. They're usually enticing the crowd by, you know, having girls dirty dancing or beer bonging or, you know, whatever it might be, but you can tell where the problem's gonna be at.
We got some adult guys over here on the back of a boat wearing, looks like adult diapers. I'm gonna go advise them that, for one, I don't think it's appropriate with little kids out here doing dirty dancing with a diaper on, and number two, that if the diaper comes apart because it's all sagging, that they're gonna be cited for littering. That diaper comes apart. Typically, when diapers go in the water, they expand and they come apart. If I see that diaper floating in the, shut up and listen to me, please.
You guys will change them.
If I see that diaper floating in the water, you're gonna be cited for littering. Okay? Appreciate that. If it's floating in the water and coming apart, you're gonna get a ticket for littering.
Puts it back on.
Puts it back on.
You guys coming to town?
No. Why don't you drink another beer and we'll talk later, okay? But yeah, I don't want to do that. Be safe. Are you driving?
Yeah, definitely.
Not drinking?
No, sir.
Okay. Good thing. Keep everybody safe. You're okay as long as the diver don't float in my water. As long as it's on you, it's fine. I guess they felt that they weren't able to use the restroom out here, so they decided to wear some diapers instead of a bathing suit. Knowing how diapers are, they come apart in the water, so we don't want none of that stuff floating in the water. That kind of stuff like that irritates me because there's just so many different types of people out here, families, everything else. You know, if you're gonna do that kind of thing, go somewhere else where nobody's gonna be affected by it. But out here, it's just not appropriate. Little kids, everything else, can't believe somebody come out here and do that.